Okay, so today I'm going to explain to you about how all the high yield points in glycosaminoglycan and proteoglycan lecture. There are three disorders which are commonly tested in all kinds of exams, and they are Hurler syndrome, Hunter syndrome, and Sanfilippo syndrome. So let me explain you in brief all the high yield point, how to differentiate Hurler with Hunter syndrome, and how to diagnose Sanfilippo syndrome, at least in the case stem, to get into the correct answer. Okay, so first I would like to explain Hurler syndrome. So Hurler syndrome is because it's an autosomal recessive disorder. That's the first point that you should remember. It has got autosomal recessive inheritance pattern. It means both the family member, like both male and female, can be affected with this disorder equally. And the second point that you need to remember is what is the enzyme that is deficient in the lysosome, because you need to note these are lysosomal storage disorders. It means there will be deficiency in a lysosomal enzyme which is degrading a specific type of glycosaminoglycan. So what enzyme is deficient in Hurler syndrome? You really need to know that. That's the must thing. So the enzyme that is deficient in Hurler syndrome is alpha L iodoronidase. The name of the enzyme is alpha L iodoronidase. This is the enzyme which is involved in degradation of dermatan sulfate and heparan sulfate. So there will be partial degradation of glycosaminoglycan, and there will be excretion of dermatan sulfate and heparan sulfate. So both dermatan sulfate, I'll write it as and, dermatan sulfate and heparan sulfate, they will be excreted in the urine. So the partially degraded glycosaminoglycans, that is dermatan sulfate and heparan sulfates, are found at high levels in urine sample. So these are the things which you are going to see in urine sample. Okay, so that is another must thing to remember. Now what are the signs and symptoms that you need to look for to diagnose Hurler syndrome? So in Hurler syndrome, there will be facial deformities. So there will be facial deformities. This is sometimes referred as gargoylism. So there will be dysmorphic facial features. Dysmorphic facial features can be depressed nasal bridge, which we refer it as saddle nose deformity, and it can be a everted ears, it can be bossing of the frontal bone, or it can be a short neck where the head is just sitting on the shoulder. That kind of deformity is referred as facial deformity, basically the gargoylism. And also there will be thick tongue, partially opened mouth. So these are features that you can see with Hurler syndrome. And now other features that you need to see in Hurler syndrome is there will be cardiomegaly. Cardiomegaly is one of the important feature you need to look for. So there will be dilatation of the heart. So the cardiac dilatation will be present, and also patients with Hurler syndrome, they die because of cardiac failure. So the patients with Hurler syndrome will die because of cardiac failure. This can be a question. So this will be a fourth order type of question where you are expected to diagnose a case, and then they will ask what is the cause of death. So cause of death in Hurler syndrome is cardiac failure. They die because of that. And then Hurler syndrome patients will have severe mental retardation. So mental retardation, which is severe here. That's the sign you are going to see in Hunter syndrome. So patients will have learning difficulties, all the issues with the learning. So their IQ is too low. So that's basically mental retardation there. And Hurler syndrome patients may have hearing loss. Hearing loss, and they can have acute angle kyphosis. They will have kyphosis. So basically they'll have changes in the angulation or the curvature of their lumbar or the sacral spine. So thoracic, lumbar, sacral spine curvature can be changed, and they can have acute angle gibbous. Those are some of the signs that we will see in Hurler syndrome. And most importantly, another important point that you see in facial deformities here, it is the corneal clouding. You should not forget about this. Corneal clouding. Corneal clouding is seen in Hurler syndrome patients. So these are some of the signs that you need to look for in Hurler syndrome patients. Now let's move on to see Hunter syndrome. Now the Hunt, let me draw a line here. Hunter syndrome patients, it's first thing that you should remember with Hunter syndrome is it's an X-linked recessive condition. X-linked recessive condition, it means it affects males. This is an X-linked recessive condition. That's the first thing that you should remember with Hunter syndrome. And the second one that you should remember and the must is the deficient enzyme is iodoronate sulfatase. Iodoronate sulfatase is the enzyme that is deficient in Hunter syndrome, and then the compounds that are elevated. So this iodoronate sulfatase is responsible, it's a lysosomal enzyme, it is responsible for degradation of dermatan and heparan sulfate. Again, there will be elevation of dermatan and heparan sulfate in the urine sample of these patients. So dermatan sulfate and heparan sulfate, both are elevated in urine sample. It is just like Hurler syndrome. Both dermatan and heparan sulfates are elevated. And then facial deformities are seen. Facial deformities are seen in Hunter syndrome just like Hurler syndrome. Facial deformities are seen. Only thing is no corneal clouding is seen in Hunter syndrome. So with no corneal clouding. That's one of the important differentiating point. No corneal clouding in Hunter syndrome. Whereas in Hurler syndrome, you see corneal clouding. Other than that, all the other facial deformities that I have explained for Hurler syndrome, you do see that in Hunter syndrome also. And then you don't see cardiomegaly here in Hunter syndrome. No cardiomegaly. And Hunter syndrome patients do not have kyphosis. No acute angle gibbous or no kyphosis. No kyphosis. Patients with Hunter syndrome, they don't show kyphosis, and also you don't see mental retardation. No mental retardation. So learning difficulty is more with Hurler syndrome rather than Hunter syndrome patients. And Hunter syndrome patients may have hearing loss just like Hurler syndrome. Hearing loss is seen. And also extra signs that you need to look for in Hunter syndrome is they will have what is called as Mongolian blue spot. Mongolian blue spot, especially it is seen on the sacral area. So that is a bluish discoloration on the sacral area. It can be seen immediately after birth also. That's an indication for Hunter syndrome. And also they will have papular rashes between the scapula. So papular painless rash or nodules. Rash or nodules. It depends. It can be seen. So these are the signs that you are going to see in Hunter syndrome. Now let's move on to see Sanfilippo syndrome, our third disorder. Now the Sanfilippo syndrome, there are four types of Sanfilippo syndrome. So type A, B, C and D, Sanfilippo syndrome. So they are all autosomal recessive inheritance patterns. So Sanfilippo syndrome is autosomal recessive pattern of inheritance. There are type YA, type B, type C, and type D. Since there are four types of Sanfilippo syndrome, so that they are all because of four different types of enzyme deficiencies. So whenever the Sanfilippo syndrome is asked, so one thing that is not asked is which enzyme deficiency is because of, it can give rise to Sanfilippo. That cannot be asked because there are four types and four enzyme deficiencies, and individual types of Sanfilippo syndromes are not generally tested in the exam. But what is tested in the exam is how do you diagnose Sanfilippo syndrome. So Sanfilippo syndrome is little different from Hurler and Hunter syndrome because Hurler and Hunter syndrome, they are dysmorphic category of mucopolysaccharidosis, whereas Sanfilippo syndrome, it is classified under learning difficulties and behavioral problem category. So that is why Sanfilippo syndrome patients will have severe learning difficulties. And they will have behavioral issue, behavioral problem. And they can get into dementia later. And towards the end, so the Sanfilippo syndrome can go in three stages. That is the first stage where it is only developmental delays. In second stage where there will be issues with the behavioral learning difficulties, behavioral problems, challenging behavioral, something like that will be there. And later in the third phase, usually between 20 to 30 years of age, so the loss of agitative skills will be seen in Sanfilippo syndrome, and they will basically become bedridden, and that can give rise to complications and they will die. So loss of agitative states, loss of skills, and becomes vegetative state, and that can give rise to death. Okay, so what are the compounds that are elevated in urine sample of Sanfilippo syndrome? It is only heparan sulfate. Remember this. This can be a question also. Which kind of material, glycosaminoglycan, that you see in the urine sample of Sanfilippo? It is the heparan sulfate. Now let me quickly revise all the three disorders together. So we have Hurler syndrome, which is an autosomal recessive condition, where the deficient enzyme is alpha-L-iduronidase and the compound that is elevated is heparan sulfate and derbutan sulfate in the urine. And then facial deformities, classified under facial deformities, patients will have cardiomegaly, cardiac failure is the common cause of death, they will have corneal clouding, and the patients will have mental retardation, which is often it is severe, patients will have hearing loss, and kyphosis, acute angle gibbous, can be seen. Hunter syndrome, it's an X-linked recessive condition, affects predominantly males, iduronate sulfatase, enzyme deficiency, dermatan and heparan sulfates are elevated in the urine sample. It belongs to facial deformities just like Hurler syndrome, but the difference is these patients do not have corneal clouding. Hunter syndrome patients do not have corneal clouding, and they don't have cardiomegaly, they don't have kyphosis, they don't have mental retardation, but you are going to see them in Hurler syndrome. And patients just like Hurler syndrome, in Hunter syndrome you will see hearing loss, and the characteristic features of Hunter syndrome which will differentiate that from Hurler syndrome, apart from having other negative signs that I have said, so the positive signs are like Mongolian blue spot, which is characteristic of Hunter, you don't see that in Hurler, and the papillary painless rashes or nodules, you can see in between the scapular areas. That you see in Hunter but not in Hurler. Sanfilippo is a different category. So it is a behavioral disorder. Learning difficulties will be present. So it is facial deformities are very less here. So there are four types of Sanfilippo. A, B, C, D. So it means four enzymes are deficient. So remembering enzyme names not necessary at this stage. Autosomal recessive, severe learning difficulties, behavioral problems, dementia. Patients can get there will be loss of skill, getting into vegetative state, and the urinary component is heparan sulfate. This is all about Hurler, Hunter, Sanfilippo, which are major mucopolysaccharidosis, which are tested in majority of the exam. Thanks for watching. See you in my next video.